Do you like cutting your subject out and putting them on a different background, or compositing different elements to create your own images? Today we're going to show you one of the best ways to make selections, and ways to refine your mask and get rid of the dreaded fringe or haloing, all here in Photoshop. In this example, we're going to cut this subject out of the background. There's a blue background here, and we want to be able to place this subject in any other background that we want. The goal here is to preserve as much of these fine hairs as possible. It will help make the composite look a lot more realistic. And if you put the subject on a different color background, you still want to be able to see the strands of hair. Selecting mask will do a pretty good job, but in this case, using channels to make your selection will help you to maintain those fine hairs. First, make a solid color adjustment layer. Put that underneath your subject layer. We'll use that for testing our selection later. We're going to start off in our channels panel. Here in the channels panel, all of our channels are turned on. All these channels make up your image. We're going to work with an individual channel. So we're going to turn off visibility to each of these channels. If we want to display just the red channel, we can hit Command 3. That is the shortcut. There's our red channel. Command 4, that's our green channel. And Command 5 is our blue channel. And we're looking for the channel that has the most contrast, in this case, from the subject's hair to the background. Looks like the blue channel has the most contrast, or the most information. So we're going to use the blue channel here to make our selection. When you are going to make a change to the channel itself, you will need to duplicate it. So I'm going to take the blue channel, and I'm going to drag it down to the Create New Channel icon. And now we have to invert that channel with Command I. And now you see on the channel that the subject is light and the background is black. So it's the lightest areas in the channel that will be used as a selection. This is a luminance-based selection. Now we need to refine this mask, because it is a mask, but we're going to do this back in the Layers panel. We could use levels to make the subject lighter, but we're going to refine this mask in the Layers panel. So on a blue copy, I'm going to hold down my Command key and click. That makes a selection. And turn on my RGB and go back into my Layers panel and click on Add New Layer Mask. Even after you cut something out of the background and get a good mask, you could still end up with a little bit of haloing or fringing. Let's take a look at some techniques to get rid of haloing and fringing. First, we're going to option click on the mask, and here is where we're going to refine our mask. I'm going to paint with white on my mask. I'm going to raise my flow up, and I want all these areas in here to be white, and I don't have to be careful right now. I'm going to change my brush mode to overlay. I'm just painting in the areas, not too far over on the edges, because we're going to take care of the edges right now. But I just want to get the inside completely white. And there's a lot of ways you can do this, but I'm going to paint like this. And this should be all pure white as much as possible. And your inside here should be completely white. Now I'm going to change my brush to paint with black and bring down my flow. I'm going to paint around the outside with a low flow. I'm just going to touch in here so as not to disturb too much of the detail. And because it's on overlay and painted with black, it's only going to affect the dark areas. It's not going to affect the light areas. And I'm trying to maintain these small strands of hair here. And I also need to make the outside here completely black. So I'm going to darken this up, make it almost completely black. Because if you don't, that color that the background was, that blue, is going to show through everywhere. And after you get most of this filled in around the subject, you can increase your flow or opacity, whichever you're using. Make your brush bigger and fill it in faster. But you want it all black on the outside here. So now we have our mask here. We've refined it a little bit. We've tightened it up. Option click. And there's the transparency. There's a couple areas to work on still. You can refine that. That we've got our areas that is going to be selected completely white, and the area around it is completely black. Point of having your brush on overlay and painting with black, you want to contract the mask a little bit, and we don't want to do it too much here. And you can change your blend mode to overlay or soft light and change the opacity or flow to work with it. I'm going to option click on my mask and turn on my fill layer. which is white. And so now you can see that we have some blue fringing here, but we also want to check the mask. So if I change the color to something dark, you can see how we have our fringing there and some haloing. So now let's go through some techniques to get rid of that. Now I want to show you two different ways to get rid of the haloing and fringing. First, let's make a paint layer. Make a new blank layer and clip it to the layers below. And with my brush on normal, and I'll take my flow down a little bit. And with a soft brown brush, like for instance, in this area right here, I'm going to sample the color of the hair and paint just like this, very easily. Going over the hair area, just along the edges, sampling the hair as I go. And while you're painting, if you're losing any hair detail, you can change the blending mode to multiply and adjust the opacity and just paint through all these different areas. You can take your time. And this is all on a paint layer. So this is just painting on a blank layer that's clipped to the subject below, sampling the hair color and painting around the edges. This is on white. I'm going to change the color, something darker. Still see that we have some blue haloing there. So now what we can do is hold down our command key and click on the paint layer thumbnail. That makes another selection. We can use a hue and saturation adjustment layer. And I'm going to make this dark again and come up here and get this hand right here and sample this color right here in this cyans. So I'm going to take that saturation down, change the lightness a little bit, and make my layer white again. Now let's try another way to get rid of the fringing. I'm not going to use a blank layer to paint on this time. I'm going to get one of my selection tools. I'm just going to make a loose selection around the hair right here. And I'm going to bring up a curves adjustment layer. I'm going to bring the level down about halfway. I'm going to make sure that this curves adjustment layer is clipped to the layers below. I'm going to click on my layer mask for my curves, and I'm going to say fill with black. And with my layer mask selected on my curves adjustment, my brush should be in normal. I can bring down my flow a little bit and paint with white over the areas where I have the fringing, the halo. Just paint in all these areas. And right now we're affecting more of what I call the haloing. We'll get rid of some of that and some of the color fringe this way. But we still have our hairs down here. We still have all these fine hairs, which is what we want. And just going around the image and painting that in. And if I want to test this to see how it looks, we still have a little bit of blue. We'll take care of that right now. But also we've gotten rid of a lot of the haloing. So let's take care of that blue. Now I'll bring up a hue and saturation adjustment layer. I'll use this hand right here to sample some of that blue. It's actually cyan. And you can drop our saturation level. We'll see what that looks like. I'm going to clip it to the layers below. And let's test our mask. So this one, I'm going to change it, and except for it being really dark, and we still maintain a lot of those hairs. So we check our masks at different colors just to see how it looks. And it's going to depend on where we're going to place our subject, on what color background, or if it's busy or not. So that's how much hair we had before in the original image. And we still retained a lot of the small hairs, even cutting it out and putting it on a different color background. Do me a favor, hit that like button. It really helps the channel. I appreciate it. Utilize channels to extract elements from the background to use in composites, especially if there are transparent elements. In some cases, you have a black or white background and you can see through that element. We have a lot of white in this transparency. We're going to go into our channels panel. In our channels panel, we're going to see which channel has the most information. Here's our red channel, here's our green channel, and here's our blue channel. It looks like the red channel has the most information. So we're going to make some changes to the red channel. So we're going to duplicate that red channel, drag the red channel down to the Create New Channel icon. And now we're going to invert the red copy channel with Command-I. And you're beginning to see the lighter areas, which are going to be our selection and the darker areas are not. So we're going to have those lighter areas be a little bit lighter. And to do that, we're going to come up to Edit, Fill. We're going to fill the contents as white. The blending mode, we're going to put on overlay and opacity at 100%. We're going to say OK. And that lightened up those areas that we're going to use for a selection. And if ever you do this same fill and it's too much, you can either use soft light as your blend mode, and you can also control the fill with, say, 50% opacity. But in this case, overlay on 100% looks good. If you need to bring out the details a little bit more, you can come up to Image, Adjustments, and Levels, and you can increase whites and darks as you see fit if you want more detail, and say okay. And now I'm going to press Command and click on the red copy thumbnail, get my selection. I'm going to turn my RGB back on and go back into my layers panel, and down here I'm going to hit the add layer mask icon, and now we have a splash of water cut out. So you can add a hue and saturation adjustment layer, and you can lock the transparency of the water splash layer, and you can desaturate the water splash, or you can change the color, anything. So you can use this in your composite, or you can throw it in a composite and move it around, change it any way you like, make it kind of artistic, and you can see the transparencies came through. Here's another example of having some transparency. We have some flames here. We're going to cut those out. Again, with our channels panel, we're going to find out which of these channels has the most information. There's red, green, and blue. It looks like red. We're not going to actually change the channel right now, so we do not need to duplicate the red channel. In this case, all we need to do is hold down the Command key and click on the red thumbnail. There's our selection, and we can turn on our RGB, go back to our layers panel, and I'll hit Command J. And now here's my selection. There's still some residual black from the background. To take care of that, we'll just come up here to Layer, Matting, Remove Black Matte. That's on a white background. So it took care of all of the residual black from the original background. And now here's an example of using that flame in a composite. I just put it in here where there was a fire, so it looks something like this. For more Photoshop tutorials, click on one of the videos on the screen now. Please like, share, and subscribe. Remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching.